Hello everybody and welcome back to Getting Wrecked and Transport Fever. So today we are not going to build boats. Well, maybe we are, because I think we can upgrade these guys in 5 years. I'm not sure how this is a freight liner with this many cabins, but okay. Now maybe it's like waltz or something. So the plan today is to start upgrading our fleet, because I want to use the Flying Scotsman, and our A3 something something, how do you see what these are, like that, A35, these guys are getting a bit old anyways, so this is a perfect time to start replacing something. Maybe I should start with this bulk guy, even if it's only 8 years old, but I already have a nice Scotsman there with 18 wagons. I think I made it like 200 meters or something. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 30, 40, 50, 60. I guess I made 200 meters. The problem is that each of these we upgrade will cost us 11 million. Well, more like 8 million if I don't place as many wagons at the same time. This guy will most likely give us like 3 million back as well when we sell it, if he got replaced, which he didn't because he's not old enough just yet. That's fine. We actually have a couple of lines with vehicles that's too old. This guy needs to be replaced. He's just expanding the catchment radius for the train station. So not the most interesting upgrade. Bow West livestock and food. Which one is that? Okay, it's this one. Yeah, this was my first A35, I think, more or less. The chemical plant is still complaining. Let's actually find that plastic and goods. This vehicle needs replacement. Scotsman. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's a bit of a lag. I think this guy's 20 meters and then all the wagons is 10 meters, so that should be about 10 wagons. Now, how about this guy? Let's keep on doing these 120 meters trains as a baseline for anything I don't know need longer trains. And then we have some passenger lines. That's not the most exciting stuff to replace, but it has to be done. Maybe I should really do these things last in the episode. I should build stuff first, because this would just scare people away. Maybe that's a good idea. Okay, so we got the bulk up and going. We got this guy being replaced. Just need this. Well, this is pretty quick. I'm saying that, but I still have like billions of trains that needs upgrading. Another chemical plant. Now we will upgrade that guy, but I still think it could be useful to have one more train. ₹120. Now, actually, I'm going to change this line because this line is right now going up to the factory here, but it should actually only go to Leatherhead, since it's going to bring plastic here and bring tools back. It shouldn't go to the factory itself. So it should go something like this. Most likely that removes everything here. Yeah. Well, that's good. Maybe this warning goes back, disappears. So what I want to do instead is I want this guy, who's actually been upgraded, I think. Perfect timing. I want this guy to take plastic and bring it all the way to our hub. So he's going to bring it to Leatherhead. A good old hub. And then it's going to bring machines and tools and stuff back. So that's all well and good. Now, last time we set up Leatherhead, and that has connection with Buckingham here, transporting goods up here, and then we also set up a line that goes between Buckingham and the city of something here, Shard. And Shard seems to need more opals. Shard goods, I guess. Not the best color on the line. That. I don't like to have to use trucks in the cities because the traffic will just get worse and worse, so sooner or later they will get stuck. But that's a problem for future times. Now let's slow things down a bit. Let's find some lines we need to upgrade. Man, there are so many. Like, this would cost me an arm and a leg to upgrade. But let's start with the steel one because that's actually something that's going to be driving quite the distance. These guys should be pretty big. Also, we will get a new state car pretty soon. So let's make them really, really large. Last I get food. This one has a lot of food waiting there. Let's get the Flying Scotsman. We need to make this pretty large. 200 meters is fine-ish. Okay, this is the one that is climbing this mountain. This one has never made me any money. It's mostly here for fun. So let's actually give this guy a cheap ass rad arrow. Okay. Like that. Because this is kind of a like an animal on its own here, so I don't really mind to have another train doing this. Otherwise I try to keep the same trains going. is this? I still don't know where we are. Okay. This one is not making me much money either. Okay, I don't really need to upgrade that guy. These guys though. This was my second line, I think. And there are plenty of food waiting here. Now, this section I should actually change a little bit. Let's just wait for that this guy to get out of sight. So I know for a fact that if I put too long vehicles in here I will have trouble. So I'm actually going to launch everything. I think I got a couple of trees as well. Maybe I should have that section still here. I have to destroy a freaking building here. That's fine. But the reason is I want to use other platform for this. So that way I don't have to bother with the other trains coming in from the right hand side if I use this this platform for going to the left hand side. Well, I shouldn't really have that signal that close either. So yeah, well, should I just use this train track? I guess so. Like that, fine. Construction is not possible. Big surprise. Not. One way, just because this wasn't actually perfect double tracks, so just to make sure. So, Tay and Gore. No, that's not the correct one. This one is Gore have stock and food. So let's get these guys to be replaced. Get a Flying Scotsman and make it 200 meters. Now the reason why there is so much food waiting here is because the food I get to this city will also be transported back to the hub, I think. And from the hub to Leatherhead and stuff like that. So everything is getting connected, so it's kind of hard to keep track on where everything is going. But hopefully they will still keep on making money. That's a lot of plastic. Plastic train. And I really need to start to learn the different line names soon, because I always get stuck scrolling up and down in this list. Plastic and goods. 17 minutes. That's a pretty long, long time between deliveries. I think I should get one more with 10 wagons, even if it's not really making me money. So, 1, 2, 3, well, this should be like 120. Since I actually calculated that before with my super math skills. That's in goods. This looks a bit bugged. Iron slag. They are pretty important as well. Oh, this is a really nice engine. So let's slow things down a bit. So the RE44. It's, well, not quick, but it's quick for being in Europe, I guess. But the lifespan of 55 years makes it really efficient in the long run. But we are doing Scotsman right now, so screw you, vehicle. Iron and slag. These guys should be pretty long. So I guess we make them 200. Seems like I have made myself clear that I will use either 120 meters train or 200 meters trains. And I need to check out this section down here. I think it's this one, yeah. Is this old? No, yeah, the state cars have a different length. So this is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15. Let's get one more. If we get these guys replaced. Okay, we only have two guys here. We need more! So, how many slow trains are still running this line? I think my passenger trains are still pretty slow. Also have this guy that is bringing bricks, but that's only really short distance. Forth here. So that's not the end of the world. Let's check the spreadsheet here. We have a couple that's making no money, but other than that, it's pretty good actually. It's not as bad as I was thinking. The problem is this is a bit misleading. Since I have replaced everything for Scotsmans. So the Scotsmans usually have a bit more capacity. So they would make me more money until they run out of goods to actually freight or to transport, because I think I might be oversaturating a couple of lines here. So anyways, let's check with 16 wagons on each. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now, there is a nice feature here in like you can clone things, clone vehicle. But it doesn't really make... Then I need to have them in the depot. I wouldn't mind if you could do that with vehicles outside of depots as well. Just take like a copy vehicle and then put it in a depot. Now I almost want to use one platform for the log train only. I mean, we have steel train and I guess that's a goods train, a machine that comes from Goldstone, I guess. This guy, Tiger. Right. Yeah. So this guy is also on the same platform as my lumber. Now I wouldn't mind it if they actually used the right hand platform to drop things off, because that's actually a place where, like, my log train will go at full speed down this lane, but the logs will be dropped off on the left hand side here, so they would actually stop on this side as well. So let's tell them to use that side. Okay. And the freaking log train is using the other side. I don't think they understand what I'm trying to do here. I'm trying to make sure that everyone is loading and unloading on that side. Okay, now it seems to work. And that steel train actually took another platform. It was like, well, screw you guys, I'm going to use this one instead. Which was actually kind of what I wanted, so that's good. But things are looking good. But like I said, it's not like this is supposed to be the way I'm doing this. But this is mostly me upgrading to Scotsman's, I guess. I don't like the fact that these guys haven't been upgraded yet. They've been stuck somewhere, maybe? Oh, it's time for new boats. And the rail bus, and the tank wagon, and the stay car. So we need to upgrade again. Nah, no, we don't need to do that because the goods wagons will not be upgraded for quite some time. But we could replace these guys with Axalp. But yeah, why are these guys not getting upgraded? Me no complain there. Alright. Well, things are looking good. I think it's time for us to look at some upgrading here. Maybe get one more vehicle on this. 10 wagons only? Okay. Alright, alright. I wonder, is this guy making any money? He is. Right. Come on, steel trains. You were like the first ones I was trying to upgrade, wasn't it? Get upgraded. Okay, oh, they are too young to be upgraded. That's the reason. In that case, it's fine. placement on that line. Oil and fuel, Scotsman. Item 200 meters, pronto. Maybe these are, no, they are not too young to be replaced, too new. So, what are we going to do today? I was going to, this is a thing. So I was going to connect all these factories down here. Let's pause a bit. So I was going to upgrade all these guys. English is hard. I was going to upgrade this station to use electrical wires, so we could add this factory, that factory, and that factory. All these guys, I want to connect them with this hub because of the industrial achievement. The only problem is when I click upgrade here for catenary and high speed, I guess. And extra tracks. I'm not sure how much will get removed here. These things will get removed, and I guess a steel down here. Yeah, that steel disappeared. Okay, well, that's fine. I mean, these guys haven't been upgraded yet anyways. So now we got wires here. Good. Now, for my next trick, I will connect all these factories with one huge. We have a steel mill down here as well. I'm going to connect all these factories with a huge train. It's my plan. So, how am I supposed to do that? I have no idea. Let's start by removing these roads so we can place stations. Now this guy is on the wrong side of the tracks. And I don't really want to have him use like a small shuttle like this, because he will only make it like, he's just going to clog this system. Now this train will not make me much money either, but it's for achievement, so we need it. So we could place it somewhere around here maybe. Or can I connect that road? Maybe I can make it that steep road. Let's see. That worked fine. We need to have a station down here and one up there. I was thinking about using the crocodile for this. I'm not sure if that's the best train for it. But I mean, since it will not make any money, I just need a really strong train that can do this. I think, why not? Well, it's soon going to be obsolete. Well, soon, it still has like 20 years of service or something left, but one 1.8 million, 1.6, I mean. That's not the end of the world. Take a corner in 80, that's fine. I like how the game is usually able to connect things like this. Makes you wonder how much programming it is behind this stuff. Nice junction. I almost want to have a bus line here just to see how they how it looks when they go up and down that ramp. They will pop a wheelie at least. Maybe catch some air. So now I don't know how to do this really. Like this guy. How am I going to connect him? I don't know. Well, we will deal with that later. I think that's a bit excessive. Let's make sure that we can get the diamond crossing here. Maybe this is something I should do for all these platforms. Let's save some space if you want to have a waypoint in here. So. Hello game, can you connect this for me? The game is like, well, of course! Of course, sir! If you have the money, we will make that happen. Now, I don't think I will need diamond crossings. Well, maybe on this one, because I think I will have a shuttle service from this factory down here. Like something like that. Will it land? Not quite. If I make it further away. Well, if I make it in smaller chunks, maybe I can do it. The problem is it's kind of a downhill here. I could almost make it go up the hill on the right hand side and then over. Maybe that's a better choice. Then you need to go over both though, which is a bit silly. Come on guys. Here I am getting my hopes up. How about now, after this climb? Alright. maybe. Let's put down the station here first. Now, I'm not going to need a large station like this right now, but it could prove useful later on, so. Screw you, collision! Further back, will that help? Yeah, it will actually not help because it's actually doing a crossing there. Oh, game! Why do you have to... Why do you have to do it to me like this? Fine. Let's try the other side. I thought that was a pretty neat solution. Well, guess not. Too much curvature. Okay, fine. Let's do it like this then. Silly game. You'll have your own freaking platform and you will be happy. So I'm just going to have a really cheap shuttle train going back and forth here. I guess that is show misc. I don't know. Misc shuttle. Make it some strange color. Well, yellow is fine. And then we need a new line that is going to go from Tane Mouth East. It will. Should I go to the far end and then back? Excellent question. Does it matter in any way? I don't think it really matters. Now, why do you like to run on only one side of the track? Something like that should work out. And then he starts riding on one side, so let's put down more signals. Need more signals. Put down signals underground is usually pretty hard, so I usually try to zoom out because when you zoom out, you actually have better chance of hitting the outside. So this is going to be surely would, well, let's have a Tane to show. Distribution maybe. Any good color for that? Some kind of strange pink. Look at this. I don't have Kate now. Screw you, game. Screw you, game. Oh my god. I forgot Kate now. That's just great. Anyways, so what's the cheapest shuttle service we can get. I guess it's a burden. Still a burden. Have a rail bus? Maybe not. Should I have the crocodile? Such a waste for this short distance. It's not like I'm swimming in cash by any stretch of the imagination. That's a cute little train. I already forgotten what I call this line. I'm pretty sure I made this show misc shuttle. Like that. Let's get a depot down here in the mountains. So for this super fancy line, we need a super fancy train. And I need to electrify the lines as well, but I'm thinking about the AE47. But anything I put here will lose money, so maybe it's better with the crocodile. It will be slow, but it's pretty strong. Let's get a crocodile before it gets too old. Let's get 6 of those and 6 of these. Not really, actually. Let's get 10 of these. This is going to be on Tay something distribution. And then we make another one with 10 of these. Set it on Tay distribution. Yeah. I know you don't have any electric lines here. But let's play the game while we electrify these tracks. Now, how long will you do one section each time here? Not quite a full screen. At least this Baden doesn't care about electric power. It's kind of strange, you don't need to make sure that they have coal and water and stuff like that, diesel. Now, I don't know how long a train can go on one load of coal, but one might think that it's not forever and ever, so I think that could be a cool idea for the developers to try to make sure that there is a reason for you to use electric trains, like if they were better in some way. Like you don't have to fill your steam engine with water and coal all the time. Like they could make the loading times faster on electric trains or something. Because they don't need to refill all that stuff. Even if I guess that's pretty quick compared to like filling the train with goods anyway. Some upgrades for our passenger trains, but for now let's join the crocodile. I'm quite happy we got to make this train. I can't play in Europe without having a crocodile. Pretty neat, but these will how much does you cost per year? 1 million. Yeah, so we will lose 2 extra million each year because of these guys. I mean, the factory up here could just as well produce all this stuff. You see, there's plenty of ways to go. That production makes me think I have something blocking somewhere. Let's make sure it's not you blocking this section. Yeah, but it can also be because I upgraded that station. So I'm guessing that's why the production went like haywire. Wagons. I think we could expand even more here. They're actually trying to upgrade more, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I don't know how many we need. I think it's something like that. Oh yeah. I am hovering a little bit too close to the zero mark here, but we do have the ability to take more loans now when it's 1950, so I think it's like 100 million or something. Having a boat service that actually makes money, that's something new. I don't think this boat service is making money by any stretch of the imagination. It made money 1 year. This guy is almost making money now when I change to cheaper trains. This almost looks legit as well. That they would ride something like this up the mountain. Like, welcome to Switzerland or something. Right. Maybe I need more passenger services here. Let's replace it with a better bus. So, what are we supposed to do? We are getting close to the end of the episode. Let's take a look at our trains. I think we had one that was too old anyways. You are driving on the wrong side of the track, thank you. I need to deal with these passenger trains. So I'm guessing Scotsman's. We actually have the BC4, so we can make 120 km an hour. So I get 5. I have a hard time to get passenger services to really work well when you play on hard, because you need such a long passenger train in order to make money from it, and it's kind of hard to make sure that you have that many passengers riding the train. Also, I need to make sure that this section is faster, because I know that this is have like a top speed of 80 on this section, because it's so curved. Let's see if he will be breaking anything. It's not even at full speed yet, so. Yeah, he had to brake there. So like 75 or something was the top speed in a section. Alright. Is there any way... I mean, we can check the line age. I'm not sure what that really means. If it's like the oldest vehicle on that line, or... Lockheed Super Constellation. Now, let's get these guys upgraded before I end this episode. So I don't have to do it in the start of the next one, because, like I said, maybe I should try to build stuff first in an episode. Oh, this is just great. So, I can't replace the steel crane any longer, because... even if it was the first thing I was trying to replace. And the reason is... because I was trying to replace it with state cars that are no longer available. Alright. So how do we do this? Do we go with the class A4 now? Because we have faster wagons? Or do we keep on using the Flying Scotsman, because that will actually be as fast as the other guys on the same track? I mean, this will make us more money, because it doesn't really cost that much more each year, so... Screw you guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, let's make it 200 and something, I guess. I wonder why it doesn't just say how many wagons you have instead of showing it like this. I'm actually going to make it a little bit longer. That will cost us all our money. All our money. Well, I will not have any money left when I have replaced all these guys with Flying Scotsman anyway. But the reason why I'm going to use the faster train here, even if we will not be able to make that top speed, is because of the price per kilometer will go up. Since we will have so expensive wagons, the small increase of a more expensive locomotive will not really hurt us that much, since we will increase the price per kilometer. $16 million each. Yeah, that's kind of interesting that I actually told the steel line to be replaced first. But it's the last one to be replaced. Quite impressive. Now, maybe there is not going to be enough steel for all these guys. So maybe I need to send one to a depot. What? This guy's only 6 years old? Okay, well, they will not even be replaced. Weren't they like... When did I start this episode? Why did they got replaced? 6 years. 7 years. I don't know. I feel like they should be older than that. Look at all the logs here. Tell him to go to the depot. See if this guy gets upgraded. I don't think he will. Nope. Alright. Alright. So... I just manually replace this guy as well? I guess so. Let's show the length here, 255. Can you find a way from that? Let's take this depot. Make it 255. Take steel. I have two steels now, so I need to make sure I actually choose the correct one. So, distribution, a lot of planks waiting for distribution. That's you. How many wagons did I have on the, I think I would have had like 10 on the distribution. Nine. I mean, I'm supposed to have like a really long train here. Like, I'm going to make this full 320. I didn't really know that this would actually... by the way, that's actually... Now when we have more expensive state cars... Maybe I need a faster train. Man, I can't have a freaking crocodile for one year and then sell it? Nope. Nope. That is not going to happen. So I will just wait and upgrade this guy, the steel train, before ending this episode. With $0 in my coffer. Going to be great. I'm not even sure if the crocodile is really strong enough for a long train like this, but should be fine. It's not going to be try to make any speed records anyway. I have a couple of really ineffective lines, that's for sure. So here comes the steel train. Let's tell him to go to the depot. Now, do we need to have one more of these guys? Not quite sure. Look at all that food. Maybe we just keep three of those. Can these guys stop using the wrong side of the track? Stupid vehicles. I'm starting to detect too many problems like that. I don't like it. I can't only blame the upgrading stuff. Where did that steel train go? Joint. Right, the Nohab. That train made my last Europe playthrough. I was only using that one more or less because I didn't care about electrifying every line. But today we are going to try to actually use electric trains. But yeah. I guess one problem here with the distribution is the fact that I'm delivering stuff here and then I'm going to drive away. With stuff that this guy has built, like a couple of machines, and I go over here. I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter, but it's a bit strange that I get stuff over here and then I drive them down here and then back. So it would actually make more sense if I drove all the way to the end and then stopped at every place. That would have made more sense. It's fine, it's fine. So let's just find ourselves a crocodile and make the outro here. So thank you guys for watching this episode where I have just been spending money and not making any money at all. But we are trying to connect all the factories now before, well, I would like to do it before the year 2000, but we will see how it goes. Maybe I need to get some more efficient route going as well, not only stupid things like this. But anyways, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you next time. Goodbye!